Welcome back. I was re-recording Nepal alphabet videos using standard romanization, and in the last couple of videos we started to learn how to go from Nepali letters to words. In the previous videos we learned how to work with simple Nepali words just using plain letters or matra, and in this video we will learn how to form more complex, more difficult words. And then these difficult words usually have half letters in them. And here are two other documents that I have linked from here. So they also have examples of half letters and difficult words. So you can take a look at them. The links to the documents will be in the video description as well. Let's begin. We start with words having half letters. In the half letter videos also, you've seen some of these words. And there I used a color scheme to make it clear what is the half letter and where the half letter is pronounced. Okay, so this here I will not separate the half letter, I will not put it alone because it is not pronounced alone. Therefore, I will put the half letters with the syllable that it is pronounced with. Okay, but still the color scheme will help you identify where the half letter is, and then the syllable will help you pronounce how it should be pronounced. Okay, the first word is pakka, pakka. Pakka. Second one, sakkhar, sakkhar. And I made a note about this one. So the last letter of the word, this is sakkhara. The last letter of the word, even though it is full, it is pronounced only half. And this you can read it either as sakkhara with the a in the bracket also pronounced. Then there will be three syllables. And if you just drop that a, then it becomes sakkhar. That's the more common way of pronouncing, then it becomes two syllables, okay? The third one is jagga, jagga. Fourth one, bighna, bighna. Notice how the half letter is pronounced in all of these with the syllable in front, okay? With the letter in front, okay? Pakka, sakkhar, jagga, bighna. Here we have some examples with difficult half letters associated with ko. So we covered this in the difficult cases of half letters. So you can see here this chakra, this first one uses the standard form, the second one uses the difficult one. Okay, so chakra, this chakra is the more common one, therefore you need to remember that. The pronunciation of for this one is such that the ko, half ko, is pronounced both sides, and it's more clearly pronounced on the second half. So chakra, so you can also say chakra, but chakra is more common. Chakra. Next one is kriya, kriya. Now one other difficult half letter with ko. Now this is how you would write it with the standard ones, but this is how it is more commonly written. This is basically half ko followed by to. So bhakta, bhakta. Similarly, sa shak ta, sa shak ta. Now, half letter ng, half letter ng, the standard one is more common, but there are also hanging forms. Therefore, I include it here. So you can see unko, unko, and this is the hanging one. So ng is on top and ko is hanging. Okay, the letter after the half letter is hanging. Okay, and I mentioned that if there is a half letter in front, the last letter of the word is always pronounced full. So this becomes anko, not ank. Okay. Shanka, shanka. Now half letters for chabarga, chuak. You can also say chuako, but that's less common. So chuak, one syllable. Juala, juala. Jhal, jhal. So you can see jha has two forms. So this is the typed form that you will see. But this one is the more handwritten, common handwritten form as well. So both of these, jhal. Anchal, anchal. I made a note about anchal sometimes written with a dot instead of half ya, but it's better to write half ya explicitly. So it becomes anchal or anchal. Difficult half letters with cha. The cha, standard cha is like this, puchnu, puchnu. But when it is followed by ya, then it becomes a little bit strange like this. So you will realize that the cha looks like a full cha rather than a half cha, but the ya changes shape, and then this is pachyura. The standard way of writing this would be this pachyura. Okay, pachyura. And this is cha, cha. Now half letters for ta barga. Katnu, katnu. Ni motnu, ni motnu. Ad kanu, ad kanu. Bad nu, bad nu. And the last one is anda, anda. So this is more or less pronounced as the na sound, okay, not really the na sound, okay. So anda. Next one for ta barga. Ta barga, you have tyag, tyag. Math nu, math nu. Dhyana or dhyan. Anda, so I have reproduced anda here because this is the more common pronunciation of anda than the one that you saw here, okay. This is more common writing, this one, but this is the more common pronunciation, anda. Now the difficult half letter, half tha followed by tha itself becomes this symbol. So here you can see patta. So this patta is actually this one, but this is not the form that is written. This is the one that is written. Okay, so patta. This is similarly vatta, vatta. So da has a lot of problematic cases. So here we will cover one example from each of them. So you can see here, this is buddha. Da is the one on top, that's the half one, and then dha is the one that is hanging, this one, the hanging dha. This is buddha. And then second one is bidwan, bidwan. And notice that bidwan, the half da is pronounced on both sides, bidwan. Maddata or maddat, maddat, this form is not written, this is how it's written, okay, maddat. Now this one is da followed by ya becomes this shape, so bidyarthi, bidyarthi, that's how it's separated, bidyarthi, bidyarthi, bidyarthi. So if you write, let's see here, bid, da is pronounced with b as well as dya, bidyarthi. Now some examples from pa varga. Pual, pual. Afno, byare. And savya, notice again here the va is pronounced on both sides, savya, savya. Chumma, chumma. Now for semi vowels, here's aya. So not, actually you can also write without this half letter, you can just say I and then ya. Aya is also fine, but this is the only example I could find for half ya, okay. Aya, aya. Luang. So notice this is how it's written, luang, literally, but the more appropriate translation is luang, or this one, W or U, okay. So luang, luang. Bala, bala. Vavya. Here again you will notice that the va is pronounced on both sides. Vavya, vavya. Now, difficult half letters of a ra, we have covered this in the half letter videos also. You'll have some example words here. Paryo. So paryo, this half ra followed by ya, this is the correct way of writing, but this is what it means, paryo. Similarly, varyang, varyang, this is what it means, okay, varyang, varyang. And next one, you will realize the half ra is not always like this, it also just climbs on top. So karya, karya. And the last one is parcha, again ra is climbing on top. Now some of the more difficult cases I have not covered here, so we'll cover in the next video. And words using half letters, these sha, sha and sa. Slok, slok. Sishta, swar. Sparsa, sparsa. Okay, one more time. Slok, shista, swar, sparsa. And ha also has some difficult forms. You can see garo. This little stroke inside ha that is going leftward is ra. Okay, so ha is half, but that stroke represents ra. Okay, so this basically is ga, half, ha, ro, ga, ro. Bahya, bahya. So in this case, both of them are fine. Ahwan, in this case also both of them are fine. Ahwan, ahwan. Huatta, huatta. Here you will see again, wo has gone inside ha and just hanging there. Huatta. And then I put here another complicated one, which is double ta, okay. Huatta, huatta. Now words using half letters from cha and tra. Laksha, you've seen this before also, Laksha. And Trayambaka, Trayambaka. Okay, so as in the previous videos, there are some slides here for you to learn the vocabulary, the meaning of the words that we covered in the lesson. I'll just pause here a few seconds. You can review them on your own by stopping the video in these slides, okay? Okay, so that is all for today's lesson. See you next time.